All right, so here he is, the UFC featherweight champion, Alexander Volkanovski. It's a title he always thought he would have. He just needed the opportunity, and you all saw what he did in outclassing the all-time great Max Holloway. Alexander Volkanovski is the total package. We make a lot about his rugby league career, and at one point, he was a 214-pound athlete who was an absolute marauder, but now at a svelte 145 pounds, he truly has every skill befitting a long-reigning champion. This division has a bunch of killers in it, and right now they're all chasing the Volk man, Alexander Volkanovski. All right, so here he is, one of the better offensive takedown guys we have in the UFC, DC. And if anyone is well-equipped to speak to this, it is you. The opponent knows what's coming. At least to this point in the UFC, no one's been able to stop.
He just has to keep him away, because the moment this guy gets close enough to either grab a leg or make body contact,
right,
now you're in trouble. He has a knowledge and an understanding of position from a lifetime of just all grappling, judo, wrestling, Sambo. He does it all, and he has just so many ways to get you to the floor. This guy once told me that if he can get your leg, he's going to finish,
right,
because he's going to give you so many things to think about, you will not be able to process and keep up with him, and eventually you're on the mat. It's unbelievable to watch him apply that knowledge to the mixed martial arts fight.
And as the wrestlers say, this is not a guy you want anywhere near your bracket.
No, you don't want him in the bracket.
All right, now let's get to the tail of the tape for this featherweight tilt. Volkanovski is 5 years the elder. He will have a 2-inch reach advantage. All right, now with the official introductions,
ladies
here
and gentlemen,
is
this fight is three rounds in the UFC featherweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a mixed martial artist, holding a professional record of 25 wins, 2 losses. He stands 5'6" tall, weighing in at 145 pounds. Alexander the Great Now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. A jiu-jitsu fighter holding a professional record of 14 wins, no losses. He stands 5'7" tall, weighing in at 145 pounds. Ilia El Matador Concoria! And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon is Dan Mergliotta.
Dan Mergliotta.
You ready?
Strikes by him there.
Great job of mixing it up, staying active, keeping busy, doing great work.
All right, so here we go. The weight and the height gives way to the action right here on one side. Maybe the division's most well-rounded fighter, taking on arguably the biggest submission threat in this division.
Because he's such a great submission grappler, I believe that this is the most dangerous fight for him in the division.
Wow.
He needs to maintain his pace, stay away from this guy at all costs, and force him to stand up with him.
Blocks the shot. Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by the champ.
Lands a big right hand early. Both guys throwing potential fight enders here in the early going. Man, is he timing his shots well here tonight, DC. It's hard to recall him being this accurate in the past.
I mean, he is so sharp. And not only is he accurate, he's also keeping very busy.
Combination lands for him. He is really putting his strikes together tonight.
I mean, he's feeling himself tonight, John. He's doing a great job of putting everything together. Look at how he turns his hip into that leg.
And the elbow continues to be the weapon of choice. Nice leg kick attack there from Alexander Volkanovski. You know it's a city kickboxing fighter if they're employing that weapon.
And you know, honestly, John, he's done that over and over again. The leg kicks were what got the belt from Max Holloway. He used that to slow Max down, get him out of his conventional stance, make him fight the stance that he's not used to. And Volkanovski was able to walk away with the belt on that night.
Volkanovski gets caught by that straight punch. His defense has abandoned him tonight.
Oh, that's a nice strike. Over and over, he landed a big body kick. Level change, leg, finish the takedown. Great job.
And they both stand up. Oh, huge kick to the leg. Oh!
Big kick lands.
Volkanovski gets hit by that leg kick. Right hand on point.
Oh!
Oh!
What a punch.
Some nice back and forth action here. Clean with the right hook. All right, lands a kick there. Pretty well done.
Really good accuracy landing that kick.
Oh, and he tags him with the straight. Beautifully placed there by Volkanovski. Final seconds of round one. Goes to the body there. 5 minutes in the books. Let's check out some of the action now from that previous round, and he really kept finding a home for those kicks.
Yeah, and why would you change it? If your opponent is not going to check, if he's gonna stand there, and he's not on his toes, and he's stationary, you keep driving those kicks into his thighs, into his body, until he makes some sort of adjustment.
All right, we'll see how it goes here in this next round. A high number of kicks landed there in the previous round, and at some point, these are gonna really start to take their toll.
They do start to take an effect whenever you're taking kick after kick after kick. And watching him fight with that knowledge and that patience shows his fight IQ.
Nice punch there by Volkan. And that one certainly found the target. Volkanovski's lower jaw now starting to show signs of swelling. Oh! Oh!
He's hurt bad. Good right here.
Oh!
Oh!
Oh! Well, Alexander Volkanovski has never lost a pro fight at 145. Straight punches we've seen all night.
Huge straight punch lands, and he's got to go very bad.
Volkanovski gets caught with that punch. Don't be afraid to get that head off the center line. Well, he has landed some good shots, DC, but really unable to string any.
Oh! What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment.
His opponent stayed upright.
I mean, he's still on his feet, but he's not up by much.
Oh, he might be out. All right, so that is as big a strike as he has landed thus far tonight.
Big, massive shot lands. Look at how tough his opponent is, though. Still standing, still in their fight.
All right, so a nice job there defensively to raise the guard and prevent any damage.
Those hands never leave where they're supposed to be, and if you do that, most times you will block the shot that's incoming.
Straight right hand, no good. Well, he has really picked up the pace here in round two, much more aggressive than we saw in round one, and now starting to find himself up in the pocket.
Look at him. That comes from him throwing that kick.
Oh, slips to avoid the right. That shot blocked.
Oh, he got a good deal too.
Oh, diving punch lands.
Oh, look at him jumping in to try to get the finish.
Right hook to the body. 20 seconds to go round two.
He has a commitment to kicking tonight, and it shows.
And that's the end of round number two. All right, so there's the horn. He got knocked down by a punch in that round, but he is able to survive. We'll see if they can make some adjustments.
He's as tough as they come. He took that shot and he kept plodding forward. He got off of his butt, he got himself off of the canvas and tried to get right back to work. But he cannot take many more of these. You don't want to be the guy that's testing how tough that your chin is.
All right, next round is now underway. I thought there was pretty good back and forth action in the previous frame.
Yes, guys, it fight. Wasn't a firefight. It wasn't two guys throwing the kick and signal.
Oh!
Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down now.
Oh, big left.
Well, just as he... Just a gorgeous shot there to end the fight. Really just the way he drew it up. He found the opening and capitalized on it to the utmost extent. Nicely done to finish the fight. Well, he's going to enjoy watching this one back. Let's take a look at the replay of the knockout just a moment ago.
It was right hand after right hand after right hand. Finally, he found the one that hit the exact sweet spot that ended his opponent's night.
And there he is after a massive knockout here tonight. Near perfect execution and a seminal moment for him here in the octagon tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Bergliotta has called a stop to this contest at 44 seconds of round number 3. Declaring the winner by knockout, Alexander!